Oh, was it my question? Right, so hi Jess. Do you want to tell us why did you decide to study electrical engineering?
Yeah, that's a good question. So the reason why I decided to study electrical engineering was because I didn't know what I wanted to study. But I knew I wanted to be in that technology sector and do something where I could really contribute to future inventions and ways to improve life. So I went for electrical, it seemed most broad, and I liked math, so that was definitely a plus. Tim, who should study engineering or electrical engineering?
Well, I reckon there's great opportunities for people who are interested in technology, but also really making a difference. I think one of the things that electrical engineers have got a great opportunity to have an input in is resolving our power crisis. If we could achieve having an equal power load over all of the days and not just on the hot summer days, that would just really reduce a lot of our greenhouse gas issues. But there's great opportunities for people doing electrical engineering to do lots of different type of stuff. Do you know there was a master's student who studied electrical engineering, and he invented a machine that would test whether newborn babies were well nourished or not, just by looking at how many blood vessels they had growing in their stomach. Now, an electrical engineer did that. Isn't that amazing?
From the University of Sydney?
You bet.
Knew it.
Why did you choose to study at the University of Sydney?
Yeah, so three main reasons. The first is that it's recognised, it's a good university with a good reputation. And I think that it's important when you're, you know, telling people where you go for university, and it's also important when you're applying for jobs. The second was, I guess, the social aspect of the University of Sydney. So I have a couple of older friends that already came to the university and told me about all the societies and clubs and how great their friendship groups were, which was definitely a plus. And lastly, the convenience of the university. So it's located just so close to Central Station, and the city public transport is amazing. And when you're choosing a degree like engineering, where contact hours are, there's a lot of them, you definitely want to be at a university where you can get to easily. What are the entry requirements?
Well, if you're from New South Wales, we've got an entry requirement of an ATAR of 92 to get into electrical engineering. Mm-hmm. And that's the same if you're doing a combined degree with arts, science, or project management. You need a little bit more to get into electrical engineering combined with commerce, and that's 95. And you know, you're doing a combined degree with law, and that does have a higher ATAR. We do have a requirement that you've done maths, and it is an essential prerequisite of a certain level of two-unit maths. But we certainly recommend that students from New South Wales have done Extension 1 mathematics. And if you are from interstate, they're the equivalent maths courses, and naturally there's an ATAR equivalent if you've done the IB, and I know lots of our students are doing the IB these days.
Yeah. What about physics, chemistry and biology? That's a common question that comes up as well.
You know, it actually isn't essential to have done those particular courses, but look, it certainly does help. There are options of possibly doing a bridging course over the summer if you haven't done physics. If you were interested in electrical engineering, I'd be certainly saying that physics is probably one that has more relevance. And if you didn't choose chemistry or biology at high school, that's not something that's going to have a really much impact if you're going down your pathway of electrical.
Cool. And how do interstate students apply to engineering at Sydney?
So if you're not from New South Wales, you would need to do an application to the University's Admission Centre in New South Wales. That's uac.edu.au. They do all the conversions from your interstate mark into what you need to get into the University of Sydney.
So can you do a major, and what are the options?
Look, there are majors available. Majors are probably more available for students who are doing a single degree, because when you're doing a combined degree, we actually make the degree a little bit smaller so you can fit it all within 5 or 6 years. You're interested in the Internet of Things, aren't you?
Correct, yeah.
Now, you do have a little bit more opportunity as part of electrical engineering, just because of the structure of that degree, that there is a little bit more scope to be doing electives and depth of things. But many of our combined degree students, they actually get to pick their major as part of their second degree, that, you know, the major that they're doing as part of their arts or commerce or science degree. The key message I have, though, about majors in engineering is, one, you don't have to do that, and two, you don't need to make a choice now. They generally are made up of the subjects you do in third and fourth year. So when you're starting first year, take the opportunity to think about, oh, I like this area or not that one. And if you do want to do a major as part of a single engineering degree, you can make your choice up in year two or even year three.
So, Tim, what work experience do students need to get career ready?
For all of our new students studying engineering, from day one, we're getting them to think about their future direction as an engineer. And from their very first lecture, their very first experience, they're gathering up hours of professional experience that they have to do over the duration of their degree. Every time that there's a lecture from someone external, every time that they might do some type of site visit, something interesting, something professionally oriented, they're gaining up hours of credits as part of our professional engagement program. The culmination of that is when you reach third year or fourth year, is when all of our students have to do some period of work experience, generally about 6 weeks or so. And I know you're probably looking forward to be doing that in the near future. So do you know anyone who lives on campus?
Yeah, I do. I know people that live on campus, really close to campus, and also a little bit further away, but have really good travel options to the university as well. So the university has quite a few of residential colleges. What's included is accommodation, all your meals, and a lot of extracurricular activities like sports and I don't know, any of music or theatre that you would like to participate in. There's also a lot of accommodation, depending on, you know, price points that are situated just outside university, and those are also really convenient to get to, and some offer food and meals as well. And then because it's so close to the city, I know a few people that live in the city or live, you know, a couple of suburbs across and catch the bus or train into uni. Do we have to find our own placements?
In principle, yes. Because we think it's important that work experience is not just about what you've gained in the workplace for 6 weeks, but that experience that you go writing an application, attending an interview, getting rejected, right? And then also hopefully finding success at some stage. But we don't throw you completely in the dark and expect you to do everything. There's lots of opportunities that we have to give students a chance to meet real engineers, make contacts with different companies, speak to the recruitment officers at lots of universities. We get lots of offers from companies saying, look, we want a work experience person this summer, and we'll make sure that we forward that sort of information, you know, to all the students who potentially need to get it. Yeah, one of the opportunities we've just created is we've created our own company called Jacaranda Flame. And we put together students in multidisciplinary teams, and they've been working in some really exciting places. Like, I saw some fantastic presentations on the work they've been doing with transport for New South Wales. And in those interdisciplinary teams, they get the hours that they need to do as part of their work experience.
Cool.
So if there was one thing that you really wish you had known when you'd started university, what would that have been?
It's a good question. That people come into university and do their degrees on different levels of experience. And if you're someone who hasn't, for example, in electrical engineering, had lots of experience in programming or electronics and putting stuff together, that it's okay. And you're probably in the majority of your cohort, and to not be intimidated by those who have. How much time do you spend in placements?
Now, all of our students have to do about 6 weeks or even more if they potentially want to do so as part of their work experience. And you normally do that in after year three or year four if you're a combined degree student.
Are there any scholarships available?
we've got lots of different types of scholarships. You know, the students who get the top marks in the HSC, they'll get some type of scholarship without actually applying. But for new students, we've got a couple of different scholarships, and one of them's called the Leadership Scholarship. But I think you know a little bit about that one.
Yeah, so I'm actually on the Engineering Leadership Scholarship. It's a really great one. We get $18,000 a year for 4 years, which is a huge bonus. So as part of that scholarship, we get so many opportunities on a weekly basis where we can get together and discuss how we've been going, or have mentoring opportunities from industry, which have been really useful. And also just a lot of talks and sessions on how we can develop our leadership, not only at university, but also in the workplace. And I guess another really good part about the Leadership Scholarship is that we need to do 2 placements as part of it. And the university helps us in looking for these internships. And I'm currently on one right now, and it's been amazing so far. What career opportunities are there?
Engineers are in demand. The employment rate of all engineers across Australia is above the national average of university graduates. But in particular, you know, in your area of electrical engineering, there's some great opportunities. Thinking about how Australia and the world is moving towards increased technology. I mean, your particular area, the Internet of Things, how all of our different devices are talking to each other. You could well be the one who comes up with with these really secure communication protocols that are going to enable your phone to control everything in your home. Mm-hmm. And we can use these things just not domestically, but also really to improve big business processes to improve our way of life. So I mean, I think your area of electrical engineering has got some great opportunities coming up soon.